Noah Galloway. You know him from season 20 of Dancing with the Stars. Well, the U.S. Army war hero has a new memoir called Living with No Excuses, The Remarkable Rebirth of an American Soldier, all about his inspirational journey from the battlefield to the ballroom. Thank you so much for being with us.
Oh, thank you for having
me. Did you like that graceful sit down on live television? I was afraid I was going to fall over. All right. You are incredible, and you talk about a real transformational moment for you. It was 9/11. It's the moment you decided that you wanted to fight for our country.
Yes, I was in college and seeing that, you know, the scenes that everyone in the world watched live on television, that was enough for me to drop out of school, join the military, to be part of the fight.
And you found a passion there, but then in December of 2005, your Humvee hit a roadside bomb, and you lost your arm and your leg in that. And your recovery was long and hard, but what kept you going?
You know, there were several things. That's what I talk about in the book. You know, for a long time, people assumed it was like this one turning moment that got me back into living my life and, you know, being a better father and getting back into fitness. But there were several things, and that's what I share in the book. I go into great detail of my depression.
Yeah, you hit several low moments.
Yes, I did. It wasn't just one, like I said, one turning moment. It was one attempt failed, another attempt failed. It was just a constant roller coaster of emotions. And I share that in great detail in this book.
I love one of your quotes in the book. You say, I needed to quit concentrating on what I'd lost and focus on what I had left.
Yes.
How do you make that mental shift? It sounds great, but it's really hard to do.
It is. I mean, I've been asked, how long did my recovery take? And honestly, it took about 5 years. That's not just physical, that's the mental and emotional effects that it had on me, and to recover from that.
And then incredibly, you decided to speak up and share your story and become an inspiration for so many people in your same situation and in similar ones. Tell me about like the courage it took to stand up and share something so personal.
Well, I mean, at first it was just me, like I said, trying to be a better father and getting back into fitness. And then, you know, I started gaining this following as I was doing things, and then made Men's Health, then I went on Dancing with the Stars. And it was incredible, the reaction from everybody. But this book, I share the sides of my story that people don't know about, the down parts. And I did it because when I was going through those struggles, I thought I was the only one. I was hiding it from everyone. And I'm hoping that it'll connect with somebody or someone that may know someone that is going through that and see those signs and be able to help them.
Yeah, about dealing with loss, whatever it is.
Exactly.
I know you mentioned Dancing with the Stars. You were fantastic. I mean, had you ever danced before? And what did you think when producers said, hey, I've got this proposition for you?
You know, I didn't want to do it. They asked me if I've ever danced before. I said no. And I didn't want to do it. They convinced me to do it. I thought I'd last maybe 2 or 3 weeks. And people were so supportive of me. I was not the best dancer on the show, but I lasted the entire 10 weeks. Me and Sharna, because of what Sharna Burgess was able to do with me, she was able to tell my story through dance. And I give her all that credit. She was able to take somebody, not just missing an arm or a leg, but no ability to dance, and make it through that entire show.
You came in third place. Congratulations.
Thank
you.
What
was your biggest takeaway from that experience?
The reaction from people and from veterans. When week five, I danced at Toby Keith's American Soldier. And that dance, the reaction from everybody was incredible. And that kept me motivated week after week to just do the best I could and to push and improve each week.
Yeah. I know that vets continue to reach out to you. What are you hearing from them, and how can we all do better to improve the relationship between vets and the rest of us?
You know, I'm hearing a lot of things from veterans, and a lot that are, when I was on the cover of Men's Health and then on Dancing with the Stars, the reaction was they were proud to see positive stories of veterans. And that's what I've been an advocate to push on and on, is to push those positive stories, not just mine, but others, that veterans are successful. And I don't like to hear the negativity that comes with veterans, because even Vietnam vets, there are successful CEOs that have served, you know, in the military, fought in Vietnam, went through struggles, you know, got help, went to college, and have been successful. And those are the stories that need to be told.
Well, it is certainly an honor to interview you, and your story is one to be read. Noah, thank you so much. Living with No Excuses is out tomorrow. And you can see more of Noah Galloway's incredible story tonight on Nightline at 12:35 a.m. Eastern, right here on ABC. Noah, thanks again.